1839, Christian Schonbein, a Swiss chemist, first identified the presence of ozone in the atmosphere when he was actually looking at the electrical discharges. He named it as ozone, which means to smell because of its strong odor, wherein ozone has been likened to the smell of burning electrical wires. But during that time, Schonbein wasn't able to describe the molecular structure of ozone.
This video focuses on the identification of ozone layer by the scientists.
It's the patient and prevention.
And the main focus of this video
is how the ozone layer was formed.
Let's get started.
This was achieved by Jean-Louis Torres in the 1860s.
However, he continued his research until he found that ozone in the lower atmospheric level could affect the people's health, in which it is present in smog today.
In 1930, British geophysicist Sidney Champman described a process in which strong ultraviolet photons photolyze oxygen molecules into highly reactive oxygen atoms. The Earth's stratosphere, which makes up to 90% of the ozone layer in the atmosphere, making our planet habitable, by absorbing ultraviolet rays before it reaches to the surface, while 95-99% of ultraviolet rays are absorbed by both oxygen and ozone.
And now, we interviewed Ma'am Tinaga, a science teacher from Bacoor National High School, to express her knowledge about the formation of the ozone layer in the stratosphere.
Hi, good afternoon. I'm Mrs. Tinagan from Bacoor National High School, Gawaran Annex, presently teaching grade 9 science. So I've been here for almost 10 years.
How does the ozone layer form in the Earth's stratosphere?
Stratospheric ozone is formed naturally by chemical reactions involving solar ultraviolet radiation and oxygen molecules, which make up 21% of the atmosphere.
The ozone layer forms when ultraviolet radiation dissolves the oxygen molecules into two different atoms. When the ultraviolet radiation wavelengths are less than 240 nanometers, those oxygen molecules combine with oxygen atoms, forming an ozone layer.
In the third stage, the short wavelength UV light has enough energy to break the molecules, making the ozone gas break into an oxygen gas molecule and oxygen atom, making an exothermic reaction. The cycle has been completed. Actually, there are two types of ozone molecules. One is found at the stratosphere and the other one is at the troposphere. The ozone that was mentioned before is a stratospheric ozone. Moreover, in the other one is a tropospheric ozone, which is harmful for us.
The mechanism for stratospheric ozone formation cannot take place in the troposphere since it is absorbed by the oxygen and the ozone layer in the stratosphere.
To give a brief information, in tropospheric ozone, they are formed because of automobiles, industries such as fossil fuels, etc. They are referred as smog since it harms of the health of the people.
Now, what causes the destruction of ozone layer? Let's hear it from Ma'am Tinaga.
Chlorofluorocarbons and other halogenated ozone depleting substances are mainly responsible for man-made chemical ozone depletion.
Well, that was sad but true. Then how much suffering we might experience if ozone layer was completely depleted?
Since the ozone layer absorbs ultraviolet light from the sun, it is suspected that a variety of consequences such as increases in sunburn, skin cancer, cataracts, damage to plants, and reduction of plankton populations in the oceans result from the increased ultraviolet exposure if there was no ozone layer in the atmosphere.
Based on your opinion, how could we prevent the continuous depletion of ozone layer?
The Congress charged the Environmental Protection Agency with issuing and enforcing rules to phase out production of ozone-depleting chemicals and to ensure proper recycling, disposal, and labeling of these chemicals. These solutions have significantly slowed the growth of the ozone hole.
We know that the ozone layer blocks the ultraviolet radiation from coming into the earth.
As the ozone layer depletes, it is continuously healing as long as the oxygen molecules continues to combine and create the ozone molecules.
Before we end, let me remind you that the ozone layer is healing in a constant process. However, as we progress to industrialization, the stratospheric ozone are now depleting in an exponential rate, while the ozone at the ground are multiplying, which affects the health of our people.
As always, thank you for listening and remember, caring for the environment is important, as we need nature in order to survive. Do not forget to keep on thinking. Goodbye!
Actually, there are two types of ozone molecules. One is found at the stratosphere. Wait lang. Ang labo. My life in a stranger's face. And it was mine.